Welcome to another episode of All Things A's with Garrett, and I'm Garrett. This is the Black Phone Filming Locations Episode 2. This is a collaboration with my good friend Sawyer Smoke. It goes by the Instagram handle Not To Say 02. You'll hear me say that quite a few times in the video. And the reason I do that is I want to make sure that you guys are checking out his page on Instagram. He doesn't have a YouTube page, but Sawyer does such a great job. He loves horror movies, but he also loves film locations, and he does a good job of doing it. He's got a great amount of different things on his page, and I think you guys will really like it. I just want to make sure you guys check it out. You can also check out, I have an Instagram page as well. I have a TikTok page and, of course, a YouTube page. And so you guys can check me out as well. I would appreciate you guys subscribing to the channel. If you like the video, please hit like. It does help the video get more coverage and get to more people. We've had a great time filming these. We both saw this movie and just thought it was great. We both came to the same conclusion and just thought it was just a wonderful film. It's got a great cast. You'll hear me praise them. Scott Derrickson does a great job with the script. He takes Joe Hill's story, and you'll hear me talk a little bit more about Joe Hill throughout this video, but I don't want to talk too much more about this stuff. I want to get straight into the video, but let me just tell you what we're going to cover. We're going to cover where Finney and Gwen, where Gwen goes to her friend Susie's house at the cut through. We're going to see where Finney gets grabbed. We're going to see the exterior for Gwen and Finney's house. We're going to see the interior, two different places, the interior shots for that. We're going to go over and see where the grabber houses are. We're going to go back. Let's see. We're going to see where Paperboy gets taken, where the Vance scene with the grab and go. Sawyer's got a cool surprise. And then there is a really cool surprise at the very end. So please stick around to the very end. It's going to be really cool. I hope you enjoyed the video, and let's go see where Gwen takes off through the cut through. So after a school scene, when Finney and Donna become lab partners, you see Gwen and Finney walking this way right here. You see 8183 behind them. They're coming down here. She's giving them a hard time, talking to them about, oh, Donna. And I just love Madeline. She does a great job in this. My youngest loves The Secrets of Sulphur Springs, but she does a fantastic job in this role. I just want to give her props. But you see them right here, and she's telling them how it's Friday and she's gonna go spend the night with her friend Susie. And this is right before Finn gets grabbed, and they come right here to this, right here in this corner. And this is where she takes off this direction, which in reality, I'm just gonna share some of those who are love Silver Bullet. If you like Stephen King's Silver Bullet, you go right through there, you're gonna get to the bridge scene with the fireworks where Marty meets the werewolf. That's a 1985 movie. That's a long time ago for those you're not into old horror films, but that's Joe Hill who wrote the story. That's his dad. They did right through there. We're talking, I mean, we're not even a quarter of a mile right through there. That's where the bridge scene is. But she's headed to her friend Susie's house, which is over on, I think, Apollo, which is away from here. She would not be. So Finn ends up walking this way, but in reality, he ends up around this bend and he comes out from behind, and then that's where we're gonna go and look at where he meets the grabber.
It's Friday, so.
I'll look after Dad.
See you, kid.
So we see in the film that Finney turns this corner. He just left his sister right down around the corner here. She's gonna spend the night with a friend. And this is the grabber scene. This is where Finney gets taken. It happens right over here. But before we get to that, how I knew this is the spot, this is the location, is that you see this tree that's over here behind me to my left, camera right. You also see the telephone pole, and you see this little power box. And that's evident. That's kind of helps, lets me know that this was the area. But this is where he meets Ethan Hawke. This is where he meets the grabber. Let's talk about Ethan Hawke for a second. Ethan Hawke was an explorer in the 80s, Dead Poets Society, most recently like in Moon Knight. The guy's got, he's a Training Day, very extensive resume, great actor. And so it's just really cool for a guy who's all about the 80s. And sometimes when you film, you get all kind of stuff in the background. But it's really cool that the fact that he's in this movie, does a fantastic job with the character. I hope they do a prequel
or a sequel. I don't really care which one, but a prequel would be really cool if they could do that. But he does a great job playing this character. But he comes out, he stumbles, he drops some his groceries right here. He has his, I think his eggs fall down, his hat comes off, and he's a part-time magician. That's kind of the deal. And he goes, he asks Finny, "Do you want me to show you a magic trick?" And he's like, "Sure." And then that's when Finny is like looking at the van, and the van is parked right where my vehicle right here is parked at for you. So in full fashion of today doing the black phone, I got my own black balloons, and I'm not grabbing any kids today, I promise. but I'm having some fun today doing this. So this is where he would have grabbed them right here and pulled them into his van. And this is, and then he lets the balloons go. I'm gonna let one go.
Bye, black balloon.
Gwenny, your dad's on the phone.
Hi, Daddy. No, I haven't. Not since school.
This could be the location that Gwen comes out of after she finds out that Finny, that she's called it, the she spent the night of her friends and found out that her brother's been taken. And it's very similar. It may not be the exact house, but I do think they had like there's an 8 on the wall there, and there's that.
So after Finny is taken, he's taken to the basement. There's a bunch of scenes there. And that's all done at the film studio that's here in Wilmington. All the basement stuff was there. There's no basements that were used in anybody's house. That was actually done in the studio. After that, it shows Gwen at her friend's house, Susie's house. And then it comes back to here. And right back here is where Finny was taken. Right in front of his house right here. This is where he was taken. This is where the flight van was. But this it's at nighttime. And the camera shows the intersection right here behind me. It shows that same tree. It shows that same light, the same telephone pole, same little power box. And then it scans down right here, and the police are talking to Gwen, or talking to Gwen's dad in the movie. And it pans. It's nighttime, so it's kind of hard to make some of this stuff out. But it pans right here, and she is sitting right here. Spot right here. I think you can even see this little flower, this bush behind her, just sitting right here. And this is supposed to be their house. And it makes sense. The interior shots were done over on Shirley Road. We're gonna go over and take a look at Shirley Road. But they even, and I'll show you a picture that was behind the scene picture. But they set up one of the houses over there with this green concrete block look on each side of the doors, and they just did it so they could have a shot of the door. The cool part of this, and sorry, you're right here with me, is that this is cool. He's wearing the Maximum Overdrive, and I'm wearing AC/DC shirts. Mm. This
not
is where
planned.
Not planned. Planned. This is, but we have it going on. It's really cool. but why this is neat is that even though the exterior shots are filmed here, and this is kind of where the neighborhood of where the fights, where they're walking down by the chain link fences and stuff like that, but the interior shots were filmed over on Shirley Road, and the house that is Sawyer calls it the Angler House.
You see it really well.
You see it real right when Deke is coming on the bicycle right there at Kenwood.
Yes.
Of Kenwood right there.
The ice cream truck.
The ice cream truck comes from the other direction. That house is the interior. Shots were filmed there, and so that's a really cool
Maximum Overdrive connection. I'm gonna do a separate Maximum. I'm gonna do a separate Maximum Overdrive video with connection to the black phone. So check it out. Maybe we'll have the, I don't know where it would be. Maybe over here. I don't know. It'll be up here somewhere. Take a look at it. Take the link. But we're gonna do that one as well. We're gonna highlight all the Maximum Overdrive Stephen King connections to this movie. But this also needs to be referenced that we're having in this video as well, that even though this is the exterior locations right here, the interiors were filmed over there, and that's just really cool to me that it's just Stephen King, Joe King Hill, how you gonna do it? And here's one little part, and I'll mention this in the next video. Joe King was in Creepshow. He's the little kid. I didn't realize that until this year. He's the little boy in the beginning of the beginning as the anthology.
Oh, he gets slapped by Tom Atkins.
Yes, that's Stephen King. That's Joe Hill. That's Joe King. I mean, that's really cool. So he's in Creepshow as a little boy. He's about my age. I'm a little older than Sawyer. I'm not going to say exactly. Just, you know, almost 50, but still. So Joe King is about the same age as I am, Joe Hill. So that's just really cool to me that he was in that. But so I don't know how much time Joe spent in Wilmington, but it's cool to me that his first film, being his first film, major film, was being filmed in Wilmington, and it's his story. And they did a brilliant job. And so just keep watching, because we're gonna hit some more locations.
So we just talked to the owner who lives here, confirmed that this was definitely the location of where Gwen, this is supposed to be their house in the film. And the reason, he didn't even really know that's supposed to be the exterior, but he knew they filmed right outside here. They wanted him to like take his fence down. They talked to him about doing stuff with the shed. They put up a fake facade right here behind me, where the covered porch area is right here. But this is exactly where I can definitely confirm now, this is where Gwen was sitting after they find out that Finney has been taken. This is the spot right here. And they even put stuff on the fence, and they came back and power washed it. Really cool. And here the owner was really nice to us, talked to us for a few minutes, and so this is a really cool thing. We're gonna go over to Shirley Road, and that's where the interior shots were filmed, and that's also where the grabber houses are located. So we just left the neighborhood of all the exterior shots, basically, for the black phone. This is actually the street of the grabber houses. So there's two of them, and there's also, this is where the interior shot of Finney's house, which is right here behind me. This was also used in Maximum Overdrive, and I do another video, the black phone, the Maximum Overdrive connections. That's a whole different video. But this right here was seen in the Maximum Overdrive, but this is where the interior shots. I showed you the interior shots. I showed you the exterior shots over in the other neighborhood by Greenfield Park. But right here inside, you see this window that kind of gave it away for me. That's when I knew that it was not, that this was the interior shots, not over at the other neighborhood. Here Sawyer had found out that they used this house for interiors. We were thinking that this was the grabber house interiors, but when I watched the movie and I looked at it and I saw the fireplace, I saw the big window, I was like, it's not the grabber house interiors. This is actually Finney and Gwen's house interiors. So I think on the front corner, you can't really see it from here, that was our Finney's room. The back corner is the back of the house, in the back corner, that's Gwen's room, used for her room. And the corner right here with the window, two windows at the end with the little white section right there, that's where he's watching TV. And you see several scenes like emergency. This is scenes where Jeremy Davies and Madeline McGraw had their scenes, some powerful scenes in there. There's one scene where like he has to like whip her, or he does whip her in the movie. And it's just a really emotional scene that happens right there in the kitchen inside this house, just really powerful. But there's a behind the scenes picture, and how I knew that they used this for the, even this from exterior, there's a Madeline posted a behind the scene picture of they had changed the door and put like a rectangle glass door, and then they put two facades on the side that looked like concrete block, and I showed you that over at the other location.
It looks just like that in its dark green. It looks just like the other, the exteriors of the other one. But they had it up on either side. So when the police show up at the door and they talk to the dad there at the front door, it looks out toward this way. But, and you don't ever really see that, but they had it just in case. And it's, and that showed me how, you know, how much they put the effort into like making things look a certain way. Later in the film, just show you this real quick, and we're gonna go look at the grabber house, the grabber houses. Finney escapes one time. He comes down the street. Right here at this telephone pole, there's some bushes and a tree right there. That is where the grabber grabs him, and it's a nighttime shot. You see this? It shows two doors. One of those doors is right here. The light comes on. You see the half circle. The light comes on. I'll show you in the video. And then you see across the street. This is from another angle, but you see the light. This house come on as well.
I just talked to the lady who lives in this house, and she told me that her vehicle here was sent in the driveway during filming the whole movie. You see this house through the window in one of the scenes, and you can see those doors right there.
So we're at the location of one of the grabber houses is right behind me. This is the one that's shown mostly in the film. You see there's a fake tree that was right here. I think there's some rocks as well. This is the iconic, I think it's 77, maybe 17 in the film. Obviously that's not the real house number here. We're on Shirley Road. We're right down the street from the interior shots of Gwen and Finney were. But this is where we see Ethan Hawke. He's got a couple times, he has the balloons in front of him, just like this, and he does a little something like this, and laughs. That's a creepy little laugh. But this is not the house in the movie. Spoiler alert here. So if you haven't finished watching the movie, you can stop it right here. But if you have, this is, I'm gonna continue on. This is where the bodies are buried in this house. There's a scene where Gwen is coming down the road in her yellow raincoat. They have rain machines out here. I think the lady who lives in this house right here, I got a video from her. Sitting with Sawyer sharing this. So this all came from Sawyer. So thank you, Sawyer. Again, check out his Instagram page, Not To Say 02. A lot of good stuff on there. And he can't be with me today right this second. But I appreciate all his help. And we are definitely collaborating on this together. But you can see out here, they had a fake rain machine. And right about there is where the five boys are. Like, it's part of her dream premonition. They're standing right here in the middle of the road. And she falls down right where the camera is where she falls down the middle of the road there off her bicycle. But in reality, this house across the street is the grabber house, the main one where the boys are kept. This is where the basement is supposed to be in the film. This is where the grabber's brother, Max, he talks to the cops, brings them inside right here, this house. This is where the padlock was on the door. This is where it shows after the cops leave. It kind of goes, it looks like it goes down into the ground, and it looks like it shows you that we go from upstairs to downstairs to the basement where he's being kept. There's no basement here, but that was all done at the studio.
This is the gym from the Black Phone. The actual school where this is at is the Trojans, but I believe the Northwest Timberwolves was put here for filming. So that's pretty cool that's still there. As well as the Timberwolf in the floor. Wow, this is so cool. This is the one spot I didn't think I was gonna be able to get. Very, very cool. Very happy to be here to document this, because I don't think the school's gonna be around much longer in the state that it's in. And I think the principal and a member of the police was standing over in this area somewhere. I can't remember if you can see the Timberwolf or not, but they're standing over here, and it's a wide shot, and Gwen's sitting up in here and all upset because they're breaking the news to the school that Finney's been captured by the grabber. Pretty cool. All right, so nurse's office. Gwen would have been laying in a bed right here. You see these three little windows pretty plainly. She's having the dream about the grabber. They had a desk set up right here where the nurse was sitting behind these windows, or in front of these windows, excuse me. They didn't, you know, it's not a huge scene. They didn't, you know, it's probably a 15-second scene in the film, but nevertheless, it took place right here.
So we're at the location of where the paper boy, Jacob Moran, who played him, did a great job, gets taken, and he's with the, what made this place, this location, Evan House, found it, was this right here. He's right in front of this little decorative part of inside the brick wall. He's right in front of there, and he's got his dog beside him, and he's putting his papers together. And he ends up being called, you know, he wants to be called Paper Boy. He don't like being called by his name in the movie. So we're right around the corner from where Bruce was taken. So it shows this. And then, so we're right here. And then he's coming down the road right here. And he throws the paper. And you see this tree right here. Get the angle here, he's throwing the paper this way. You see both these, you see the corner of this house in the background. And then also one scene, just so you see an angle like this, and you see that it says 217 on the little address marker by the sidewalk. Another evidence of this is the place. And then, what's really cool on this, then it shows him, you know, he's riding down the road here, and this is where we see it's only a couple times in the movie, but you see the Rocky Mountains digitally added, and as you can tell, there's no Rocky Mountains here, but it's really cool how they do that. So right above there, we would have seen that. Then when he's taken, he's coming about this direction, and they show, we're right here in front of the same house where he threw the paper, and about his dog's about right here, and we see the van. It kind of has this panned feel where he does like this, and then it shows the van, and then it goes around the corner right there, which actually leads you right to where Bruce was taken. This is the view we would have got, kind of like this. Kind of how it would have said grab and go, and how fortunate it was called the grab and go. It's actually Sam Food Mart here in Wilmington, across from Church's Chicken, and the ice machine, you see it as well, right there. Yeah, about being called the grab and go, is that being the grabber is the name of the villain, and then we got grabbing and go. So I just talked to the cashier. He said it was definitely filmed inside here. So the fight scene would have been right here with, we got Brady Hepner played Vance right here. Definitely has a Billy Hargrave from Stranger Things vibes going on. But with the fight had been right here, they've been going at each other, and I do think this pole right here was used where we see Benny watching it, like kind of in this dream sequence type thing. He's explaining it, you kind of see him, and then of course he gets dragged out the front.
Thank you.
About right here.
This is, I think we see, this is where we got put into the police car. We would have saw a barbershop, stuff hanging on that right there.
There's the view from this way. Ice machine, you see it in the background a couple times.
But how I knew Sawyer was the one who, he had a tip from somebody who said it was filmed across from the church's chicken. But how I could confirm this, we couldn't, you know, have some screenshots. We couldn't really tell, was there's a picture, I think, of Brady and Vance and Finney together, right, looking down this alleyway. And this is kind of how I knew there's a picture of them together. And you can see the light right there, and you can see the telephone pole in the background, and you can see this air unit right here. But they're standing right here. There's a picture of them standing right here in front of the main road where I would be. Kind of like this, but it would have, I was just somebody taking a picture from it, just the background would have been like that. Then one more cool fact about this location, about this being used here, is that the Silver Bullet, Corey Haim, where Marty goes to school, is right down this road about half a mile on the left-hand side. And that's where that was filmed. And this is filmed here for Joe Hills, AKA Joe King's Black Phone. So pretty cool. There's a Silver Bullet and a Black Phone location really close.
What question is that? Do you even know who you are?
I'm Finney Blake. Yeah.
Right here. This is it.
This is what?
The horrifying nightmare end of your pathetic little life.
Where at the end of the movie, this is where Finn comes out. We can come a little bit more this way here. And he comes out, you can see him come out the door. He comes out right out these steps, and this is where him and Gwen interact. They hug each other, and the EMS is right here. And then this is where the dad he comes up, and he has a moment with them. And you know, it's kind of a moment of repentance, but you know, the kids are kind of like, all right, Dad, whatever. But it's kind of like, it's just a sweet moment between Gwen and Finn, and I think that's really, it's really cool. And again, it shows you the bond that those two actors developed on set. I think they did a great job together.
Detective Wright?
Thanks, Chief. The perpetrator known as the Grabber owned two homes, one where he kept the victims while alive, and a second empty home across the street where he buried them post-mortem.
At the end, he comes in through those doors right there, comes walking down the hallway. People are talking to him, and they're making whispers. Man, I thought he'd be bigger, and man, he took him on. And I think the bullies were sitting right here. They're not gonna mess with him now at all. He passes them. He comes in, there have been a science club poster right here. Here he came in, which is, and that one's still there too, Science Club. It is the same one. And you would have seen those pictures on the back. He kind of walks through. This place has been trashed since the filming of this movie. But making my way over broken glass. And obviously there would have been lab tables over here. What to do to get a shot. And behind, he sits with Donna back at his table. This cabinet behind him is very prominent. And she goes, hey, Finney. Welcome back, Finney. And he goes, you can call me Finn. And this is how it ends right here. Very cool scene at the end. Kind of positive to it, and he gives just a cool, I think it gives a cool vibe coming in at the end of the movie. I think it ends on a high note. I can't wait to see. Hopefully there's a sequel, prequel. Prequels will be great for this movie.
Hi, Finny.
Call me Finn.
Okay, we're at the last location, and this is really cool, and I can't wait to show you this. And this is a big surprise, a big reveal. Thanks to Sawyer. Sawyer came through with this, and he found this, and you guys got to check out his page, and he'll have more information on this. But let me show you what the big reveal is. We are looking at screen used. The grabber van from the movie. There's actually two of them. Here's another one. And this one had a sticker. You can see a little bit left on the residue left of it. But they had two of them. It's right here in Wilmington. And he stumbled upon it. And I'm just super psyched about this. This is just so cool to be able to not only find this, but to see it and to be here and look at it. And let's see, I don't think you get to see inside like this, but there you go. And I've already looked, there's no black balloons on the inside. Here we go, this way. And then of course, you know, the back is, well, it's the back, it's where it all.
Well, these balloons have seen better days, but I just want to thank you guys for watching this video on the Black Phone Film Locations. Check out Sawyer's page. Thanks to Matt for recording and being here with us and finding some locations. We've had a great time, and this is a great way to end this video. If you like the video, hit like, hit subscribe, and check out the other video on Maximum Overdrive and Black Phone Connections. And I'll catch you on the next episode of All Things A's with Garrett.